Welcome, welcome, welcome to Love My Kidneys.
Peace
welcome,
and peace
and blessings, fam. We thank you all for tuning in. We really appreciate it. Of course, you could have been anywhere and everywhere, but you chose to take your time to be right here with us, and we really do truly appreciate it. You giving us some of the most valuable thing that you have, and that is your time. Whether you look at it now or in the future, whether you look at it for 1 minute, 5 minutes, the whole time, we appreciate you. We just ask that if you get any value out of this, that you would share with those that you know that would benefit from it, all right? We really do appreciate that you would take the time to give us a little bit of space in your mind. So we really appreciate that, and welcome, welcome, welcome to Love My Kidneys. Love My Kidneys. Love My Kidneys is the show designed with your healing in mind. That's right. It's a show designed with your healing in mind. For those who do not know, you may be new to this, that my beautiful wife right here healing from chronic kidney failure stage five. She is healing from chronic kidney stage five. And what we decided to do is, with what we're doing, we decided to document the journey, letting people know that we're on the journey to heal from chronic kidney disease.
Right.
And we're not going to just accept it sitting down. We're going to fight to the very last nail.
That's right.
And we're going to overcome, because we know that we got a God that heals all things.
All day,
and we're going to put the body in the environment that it can heal. We got an exciting show for you today, because many of us are in the house right now, and many states are going back on lockdown. So we decided, in the spirit of entrepreneurship, in the spirit of what's going on, that we could talk about learning while you heal. Okay? We can talk about learning a new skill while you heal, family. But before we get deep down into the show, we want to give you a little bit of inspiration, all right? A little bit of inspiration. A little theme music. All right, fam. We got a few quick announcements. We going, oh, she want a little more.
Well, no,
okay.
Go ahead, let it roll.
No, okay. Yeah, okay. Good. Okay. Yeah. That's what I was going to do. She want, we got a few quick announcements for you, fam. I'm going to turn it up a little bit. You know, that track is made by yours truly. That's me. That's right. DJ Ali.
DJ
yes, sir.
Ali.
All right. All praises due to Allah. But anyway, family, you already know if you've been watching us, following us. If you don't know, if you're new to the channel, we got Shot Blacktastic going on tomorrow, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. That's Mountain Standard Time. That's 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. tomorrow, live right here on Facebook. That's right. We're going to be shopping Blacktastic. We're going to have black vendors. And we're going to have black people shopping with black vendors, circulating black dollars. That's right, on Black Friday. How incredible is that?
Right.
We're going to snatch back some of our own dollars. That's right. We're going to beat the myth that it stays in our community for only 6 hours. So we want you to come on tomorrow and join us. Tell your family, tell your friend to come on and shop Blacktastic with us tomorrow.
Right.
Come on and shop Blacktastic with us tomorrow. Again, that's going to be 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. That's going to be Mountain Standard Time, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Okay.
Also, my beautiful wife has a class coming up December the 5th. That's December the 5th. She's going to be teaching the sacred science, a holistic healing jewelry. We're going to get involved with Rings 101 and Earrings 101. If you would like to take that class, that class is only $50 and includes your tools, your stones, your copper, everything that you need, that you may be able to take that class, and you're going to get a one-on-one with the queen of rap. That's right. You're going to get a one-on-one with the queen of rap. So that's on December the 5th. The jury class, we want to see you all there. We're asking for all payments by no later than the 25th, which is actually today. So we're going to have to extend it a little bit. You know, for those of you, we're going to...
If you have your tools...
If you got your tools, you got up into the time. But if you need your tools, we want to get that to you. So go ahead, pay as quickly as you can. Inbox us, DM us, private message us. However you want to say it, just let us know you want to be involved in that class, okay? Definitely a definite treat. It'll be a definite treat. My wife have talked from the U.S. all the way to Belize. That's right. That's a true story. I'm not just saying that. That is absolutely real. And we are thankful for those blessed hands, that blessed mind, and that beautiful heart right here. All right, family. So with that said, we're going to bring on your host, my sister, my wife, my friend, whom I love so, so much. We're going to bring her on with a round of applause. My sister, your friend, my friend, Nafisa Ali, the queen of rap. Come on.
All right. Assalamu alaikum. Peace and blessings, fam. Praying everybody is wonderful out there. I love the theme music. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Okay. Can you see me?
I see.
All right. And... hey, praying everybody is good out there. It is another awesome day of healing today, fam. Another awesome day of healing. I know many of you are out there celebrating with your family. You all around that, getting ready to be around that table with all that food. Be selective of what you're eating, okay? Be careful of what you're eating. You don't want it to interfere with the healing you already got going on. Okay, so if you've been on this healing journey and you've been striving to eat better, live better, you don't want one day to set you back 3 weeks. Okay, so no pork on your fork because that's not good for you. Try to eliminate as much of the meat as possible. You know, stick to the veggies that they got available. Okay, and try to eat good. You know, if you're at home by yourself, it's still, you know, you don't want to just grab a bowl of cereal. Eat you some good food. Get you some of them Navy beans. Y'all remember them tacos? Did anybody try the tacos?
Come on,
I pray that you all did.
Who that? Those Navy bean tacos.
Yes.
Go ahead, put it in the chat.
I know.
Go ahead. And if you didn't, the rest of the show is still up on the Love My Kidneys page. If
yes.
You didn't get an opportunity
yes.
to and try that
it
recipe.
It was absolutely delicious. So, guys, today we're going to talk a little bit about learning a skill while you heal. Learning a skill while you heal. And one of the reasons that we want to talk about that today is because, of course, like my husband mentioned, tomorrow is Shop Blacktastic.
That's right. Shop Blacktastic.
Where we're going to be working with entrepreneurs, predominantly in the Black community, that have started a business during this time of quarantine. And I think it's important for those that are healing from kidney disease or any other type of dis-ease in the body to focus on something besides your dis-ease, okay? And I know a lot of people are in center and you have those ups and those downs, but one of the things that really, you know, help you feel better is that you do something that you love to do, something that you've always wanted to do, you know, something you thought about doing, something that looked kind of cool, you know, that you saw somebody else doing, you know, but they were passing thoughts. It really didn't develop into anything. Well, this is a really good time. One of the things that you all know that I do is I design holistic healing jewelry, right?
Maybe you didn't know.
Maybe you didn't know, but that is one of my passions that I have actually been doing for the last 10 years of my life. And because it's, you know, natural stones and copper, all of that has been part of my healing process. You know, as I create, my focus is on healing. So I'm listening to, you know, positive thought, you know, bringing my vibration up. I'm listening to music. I'm, you know, concentrating on God into my prayers and my meditation, you know, as I hold the stone and, you know, feel the energy from the stone. It's like that moment that I'm connected with the God, right? So for me, holding those stones in my hand and, you know, being creative, it takes my mind off of any pain that I'm experiencing. It takes it off of any emotions of depression, you know, that sometimes you feel when you're going through something physically. So for me, it has truly been a lifesaver because I was able to, you know, focus on that and put my energy into that and be in prayer and communication with God, which automatically, you know, for me, puts me in a good mood. It makes me feel good, you know, and I think that's important that when you're in this time of healing, it's like that plant, like that flower, you know, it starts as a seed. And that seed is buried in the earth, and it has to pull from the universe under the ground. You know, it's got to pull from the nutrients from the dirt in order to build itself up, right? Before it pops up and say, "Hey, here I am. I'm growing." My beloved sister Fatima, she's been posting pictures of her plants and the new growth. That, you know, she wakes up in the morning and is sticking this little green head up, you know, saying, "Hey, I'm here," you know. And so that's how we have to be, right? In this hour of healing, you're in this cocoon process. If you take yourself in and just kind of see, what did God put in me? What did he put in me that I can bring out of me and present it to the world?
Come on now.
And when you do that, when you go within yourself, you'll be surprised, you know, even through your pain, even through like this show here, Love My Kidneys was born out of my pain.
Come on now.
And I love what God is doing with this Love My Kidneys, because he's showing me that so many people need to hear what I'm going through so that they can be strengthened and that they can not go through it or come through it and feel good about themselves in the process of coming through it. And then we can connect our forces and help millions of people, because it's a million of us struggling, not just 1 million, but millions across our planet, fam, that's struggling. So we have to heal. And one of the things that I thought was so important to talk about today was healing through our skills. Right. So I'm going to go over a couple of things that I thought about that would be really good for if you don't have an idea, you know, of what it is that you want to do or that you can do. I'm going to give you a couple of ideas of what you can do. And I think I probably got about 20 of them, might not get through all of them, you know, especially if you have some questions or even some thoughts or things that you're doing, you know, or things that you thought about doing. You know, go ahead and share it into the chat and we'll talk about it. Okay.
All right. Before you get started, let me give a shout out to our big brother, Brother Jermaine.
All right.
I believe peace. That's Brother Jermaine from Chicago.
All right.
Peace, I believe peace. That's my hip hop giant.
Is that true, brother? If not, we don't mean no disrespect to anybody else, but let us know who you are. And we appreciate you stopping in and just taking a listen, and let's talk about it. You know, what things have you started working on as well? So do we have any other comments or thoughts or guests?
I don't see anything so far. Nobody's asked anything yet.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
I don't see anybody on your end.
Oh, praise be to Allah. I think, Brother Jermaine, I think you were in a couple of weeks ago, you're the technician that right. That worked with dialysis patients. So yeah, let me know if that's you.
Yeah, yeah, I believe that is our brother.
Okay, yes. He said it is a science. Absolutely is a science. And because it's a skill that God gave you that you learned, you decided, you know, this was my passion. And although you're not one of the ones that is dealing with kidney failure, this is an hour for all of us to develop what it is that we have, because in the new world, the kingdom of God, we need everything, because we have to continue to heal from this these diseases that have attacked our bodies. So, you know, with that, brother, I think that's excellent. I'm so glad that you want to continue to use that as a skill to teach others. My husband is now a tech, you know, dealing with me and dialysis, and he's learned so much. And he don't even know that God gave him that skill to help other people, because I'm not going to be dealing with this always, you know. So it's definitely something that Allah is blessing him to learn and practicing on me.
You know,
he's doing a great job.
Just really quickly with Brother Jermaine, let me just say this to you, dear brother, that yes, it is a science, and you've always wanted to teach it. So what I would suggest to you to do, brother, is to actually go ahead and start you a podcast. Go ahead and start you a podcast where you actually talking about your journey. And if I remember right, you was doing that over 20 something years. So you've experienced a lot of different things that people want to hear about. You've experienced the good, you've experienced the bad, the ups, the downs, and all of those things. And you can definitely tell a great story with your podcast, brother. So if you haven't considered doing that would be an absolutely wonderful journey for you. Mm-hmm. And it'll actually start your journey on the ability to teach what it is that you know. And you can also become a consultant via online virtually as well. And, you know, you can get the little body dummy. Now, I guess that's what you call it. And actually show them how to put the needles in and everything like that right there online. So you can actually teach right there online from the comfort of your home. Right. You just set up your house. Yeah. Kind of like a studio, brother, and you can actually charge hospitals and things for that, because you got over 20 something years of experience. So it's not something that you really have to wait on. It's just really a matter of you going ahead, starting it up, and just jumping in with both feet.
Right.
And getting it done, because you got invaluable experience with what it is that you done, and nobody can put a price on that, brother. So if that's what you want to do, if you want to talk more about that, how to get that done, then I'm here to help you on that journey, to help you start that podcast, brother. And I mean, we can talk about some things. Of course, you've done it, and I'm doing it now with my wife. So you got 25 years of experience or more. We can definitely talk about it and share with the world what you know, because there's a lot of people that really need to know what it is that you know, because dialysis and kidney failure is on the rise.
Yeah, unfortunately
it is on the rise. So I just wanted to jump in and just say that, brother, just as an idea for you.
Right.
So a podcast, you can do that on Anchor FM. It's free and it can be monetized as well. Okay.
You know, when you said that, it made me remember when we were learning how to cannulate on me, right? It's like you can't see up under the skin. You know, we don't know where that vein is.
Right.
And so that was really a challenge in the beginning, learning where the vein is, understanding, you know, that you have to go into the same spot once you once you you're cannulating, we didn't know. I didn't know how thick the vein was. None of that. So I mean, that is like, especially with more and more people doing home dialysis, man, I think that is so valuable. And I don't think anything like that is on YouTube University right now. So you would end up with a lot of hits on that. And, you know, after a while, it will become monetized and you can actually receive payment.
Yeah, and you can monetize it while you're going by charging people to take the class.
Yes.
I would probably start at about $25 or so. I would probably start at about $25 or so just to get it started. Of course, it'll cost more than that. We had to take 10 weeks to learn this. 10 weeks to learn how to do what we're doing at home. So you make and do it like that, and you know how long it took you to learn in regards to that, you know what I mean? Because you've done it for so long.
Right.
And, you know, so I definitely recommend going that route. And if you haven't considered the ABS tribe, I would definitely say that you should get involved because this is a group that can help you to build that business like no other, Brother Ben, Brother Jake. And man, it's just a whole tribe of people that do a host of things. You know what I'm saying? Again, not trying to take over the show, but I saw my brother. He had an idea about a business, and this was learning the skill while you heal. So we just want to kind of talk into the different skills and how you can develop. So I'm going to give it back over to my wife.
Yes, sir. So I think that's excellent. And that's for anybody that's on here, anybody that's listening. You know, you just think about your experience in life. And if that's something that you enjoy, something you were passionate about, but now you're ill and you're at home and you're unable to get out into the workforce, then, you know, having that presence online, you know, can definitely be an avenue for you in teaching. Okay. So teaching was one of the things that I thought was a good way to make money, is teaching whatever it is that you know how to do. Mm-hmm. Let's say if you were a school teacher and you, you were a school teacher, right? And you taught math. Well, now you can actually teach that, and you don't have to have doesn't have to be 5 days a week.
Right.
So for me, we teach, or we have our, I don't really like to call them shows, but for lack of a better word, we have our shows on Thursday, Thinking Thursday, right? So every Thursday we're doing 3 shows.
Right.
And so that's where that's my day to work in front of the world, is on Thursdays. During the rest of the week, if I get a little bit of extra energy, I'll do a quick little video. You know, I'll definitely post some pictures about the business, because, you know, those are the other days. So you don't necessarily have to feel great every day. You know, pick a day out of the week. If you don't usually dialyze on Saturday and Sunday, right? So maybe Saturday is your day.
Right.
Teach what it is that you have already learned and you know how to do, but you're unable to be in that field that you used to be in because now you're on dialysis. Right. And as you start doing these, even if you just pick one day out of the week for 1 hour, you will be surprised how that will fill your life with more energy, because you become excited. And then when people respond, you know, to you as you grow, and they talk to you and they're asking you questions, then now you want to feed. I think that's our natural, you know, responses. We want to feed people. We want to educate people. We want to share with them what it is that we know. We want to help. I think that's just natural across the board, whatever field you're in. Even if you're a computer technician, you know, your desire is to fix the problem and make somebody happy.
Now, I just show you to what she just said. Of course, if you like me, I was a tech for Apple, level one tech, and I did everything on the phone. And basically, I help people fix their iPads and their iPhones and their iPods and their Apple Watches without them, me even being there with them, just talking them through the process. Mm-hmm. So it's a very real thing that you can actually make something out of that. It's a very real thing that you can actually make something out of that. And they paid pretty good, too. I mean, I was working for a Kelly Services, but we were under contract with Apple. So that is really something.
Right.
Yeah, brother. I know you are glad with what's going on with COVID, getting out of that medical field. But at the same time, you know, like you said, anybody not necessarily, you know, that is because of what's going on, people still need it. So you can do offer your, like we said, offer your service virtually because you even were at Stanford and taught. So that right there is huge. That's a huge thing, a big deal. When you put that name behind you, you know what I'm saying, and saying you work for them, even if it's 3, 5, or 6 months or whatever it may have been, you can actually put that and say that that was something that you did. It's like a chef's resume. If you work at certain restaurants and you work there even for 3 months, you know, they know how it go, and you're going to learn from the best of the best. So when you say Stanford, Radcliffe, Yale, Oxford, all of these places, you know, and you put that on, you've done that and you trained there, man. You know, you can actually, that right there says a lot. Plus, you got 20-something years of experience in doing that. So you know what you're doing. That's right. My point. You know right. What you're doing, and you took all the trainings and all of those things. So you can bring everything that you've learned over those years, and actually you can formulate a curriculum to be able to help others learn how to do it.
Okay,
in
well,
a real way.
I'm going to let y'all talk about that on... You know,
yeah,
on the side, Brother Jermaine, we love you, but I want to talk about some other things that that, you know, other skills that people can develop along the way.
Go ahead.
Right. You know, and I think what you have is valuable. I do. I truly do. And, you know, thank you. The way we're dealing with all of this is online. And that's what we do. I work from home and my husband works from home. So even though I am, you know, healing from kidney disease, I keep myself busy. I keep myself so busy that I don't have time to focus on not feeling well. And, you know, a lot of you may already know I'm dealing right now with some pain, which throughout my life, I might have dealt with diabetes and high blood pressure, but I never had to deal with pain. You know, this is a whole nother experience for me. So what is helping me through the pain is really focusing on my business. You know, not just the jewelry design, but MindSpark Creation helps to promote other Black businesses. So I'm focused on that. I'm talking to vendors. I'm talking to entrepreneurs. Excuse me. I'm looking up, you know, new products to sell on my Etsy page or on my website to help somebody else along their way. So I'm focusing on that. Allah has now brought Love My Kidneys into focus for us to create it as a program and a system to help other people heal from kidney disease. So now, oh, that's a whole nother baby, you know, that God has given me to work with. So, you know, I'm staying busy and I'm learning that the busier I am, the less I even think about, you know, what I'm going through, and my body is healing every month. Fam, for the last 3 months, my numbers have been getting better and better and better and better.
That is true.
I'm using less and less medication. And I just recently talked with my naturopathic doctor, and he said, okay, we're now ready to move into 1 meal a day. You know, so it's a process. And my plan is by December, the, I can't say the first, because the first is my son's birthday. Well, I still, because he does 1 meal a day. But anyway, my goal is at the beginning of the month to really start on the one meal a day. And I'm moving into that by eating my fruit in the morning and not really eating too much of the eggs, because I would normally do two eggs and toast. So now it's more like fruit and toast. And I have to still get my protein in. So, you know, I'm going to have to work that into the dinner meal on a regular basis. So, and I have protein. Yeah, I do. And I have to take it and just do it. But anyway, getting back to the business. All right. So, well, now that you said that, brother, it's all in your food. That is so true. That is so true. It's what we eat. So that's a business, fam. Healthy eating.
Yes.
Now everybody's going crazy with the vegan. But we know that the person that started vegan eating did not know anything about nutrition. His whole point was to stop eating animals. That was his only point. But there's a science to this body. This body don't function off of your desire to not kill an animal. That's right. Not what the body is designed to live, you know, off of what's on the earth. It's the way in which you do a thing, right? So we know the meat is very difficult for the body to digest. Therefore, you don't need to put it in your body, especially if you're dealing with the illness. You don't need to give your body anything extra to harm yourself. So you want to remove the meat. So now that you don't eat meat, what can you replace that with until you are able to do your veggies and, you know, not miss the texture of meat?
Right.
There are options out there that you can explore. So as you're healing and going through your process, get in the kitchen and experiment with some things. Mm-hmm. There's a sister I just found out, and you all probably been seeing the little commercials about the goji berries or the goji chewy gummies or whatever they are, but it's made with apple cider vinegar. So this sister went into, and it is vegan. It is, you know, no animal products in it at all. But she went in her kitchen. She went into the lab and she said, I need a product that's going to give me energy. That's going to give me some vitamins that my body needs. And I don't want no animal product in it because I'm looking out for my health.
Right.
So she went in the lab in her kitchen and developed this product. And now it's blowing up everywhere. That's everywhere right. I turn, I'm seeing that commercial. So you can do the same thing. Go into your kitchen and develop a product. If you like crackers, what can you use using vegetables and the best of wheat? You know, to create a cracker. It may be something that nobody else knows about. Right? It may be something that nobody else knows about. So you can use that. But my point is, while you're healing, take what it is that you love to do. If you love to cook and create, go in the kitchen and you can create something like that. Or if you have a routine, right? You have a routine diet that has helped you to lose weight. And these recipes, and this is what you can create a cookbook. I know there are a billion of cookbooks out there, but there are people out there that have never had the opportunity to have your cooking, to have your ideas of how to, let's say a kidney. It's just strictly for kidneys and feeding the kidneys.
Right.
I would love that book. I would purchase that book. If you say, okay, you need to take hibiscus and cucumbers and beet juice and drink that in the morning to activate your kidneys, get them working, get them moving for the day. And then for dinner, you know, you're going to have navy beans and asparagus. That probably don't sound good together, but my point is this. If you develop a cookbook specializing in feeding the kidneys and cleansing the kidneys, man, that book would be out of sight.
Yeah.
That book would be, and not only that, and as if you create it as an ebook, then you can sell to people all over the world, like quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Yeah.
While you sleeping at night, you will be making money.
Right.
Now, if y'all don't do it, I'm going to do it, because see, the thought just came. And, you know, once you put it in the universe, it's out there. So either you can do it, or in my spare time, which I don't have a lot, but I'll create that, you know, because that's what I'm doing. I'm working on, you know, a real diet for myself. And, you know, as you all will see, this weight starting to come off because of the way that, you know, I'll be eating. And so I'll put it in a book if somebody else don't jump in it and make that happen.
And of course, How to Eat to Live will be the base of that book.
Absolutely. Absolutely. How to Eat to Live by the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You know, you got to know that. And for those that, brother is dropping some real jewels in the chat. So make sure that you're looking at the chat, because he's talking about the avocado and, you know, cheese being high in phosphorus, which is very dangerous for the body. We got to do our research. We have to do our research as we're learning, because we want to bring actual facts to the people, right? You know, we don't want to mislead people and give them, you know, the wrong ideas. But at the end of the day, fam, you're responsible for you. Don't depend on somebody else to just feed you and you not go and do some research for yourself. That's vital. So we talked about teaching. We talked about cooking. What about candle making?
Come on now. Come on now. Yeah.
Candles are part of my process.
Yes.
When I'm creating my jewelry, because it's the fire that I need. But right. I'm particular about my candles.
Right.
It's got to smell good. And I don't want fumes that's going to harm me.
Right.
You know, so you have to be careful with the type of wax, you know, that you're using.
That's right.
So whenever you're doing something, in my opinion, it should be natural. It should be holistic. And it should be healing. Whatever it is that you're doing, even if you're an engineer or you're a tech, you know, and you're dealing with technology, then it still should be something that's going to elevate us to the next level.
Right.
And not harm us, because, like, you know what they're saying with the 5G, that, you know, the level and the vibrations that it's on that is harmful to the body. Well, maybe there's something in that we could still use the technology, but you can correct some things in that. You got an idea. My husband said his uncle had the ability to challenge Windows.
He did.
Because he knew their flaws and their mistakes.
Yeah.
But he didn't take it to that next level. That's See, fine. We are at an hour and a time that we have to take it to the next level. If God has given you an idea of how to do something, then taking it to that next level, right? And making it happen. You can do this. Don't you doubt. Let me say this before I go to the next one. Don't you doubt yourself for a moment. Because if God gave you the idea, then he's already given you the solution on how to do it. He's already put the people in place that you will need to achieve your goal. You're going to have some challenges. You're going to be moving straight ahead, and then, you know, something may happen that knock you back, but you get up and you keep moving forward. You do not let anything stop you from what it is that God put on your heart and your mind to do.
That's right.
And we have to encourage one another on that. You all need to encourage me, sister, keep going.
Right.
You know, we didn't see you last week. I pray you well. Get on up.
Right.
Keep working.
You know, I just got to share this quickly, and then she's going to move on to the thing. One of the books that we're reading right now is Sister Wendy Muhammad, The Mind of an Entrepreneur. Mm. And one of the, she talks about how we put ourselves in boxes. Mm. And she talks about the box that you put yourself in. She talks about that box that you put yourself in and how you lock yourself in that box with bad habits and bad mindset and hanging around people that's not really helping you to get your goal accomplished. She's talking about that. So when you getting ready to engage in any of these businesses, already know that there are going to be challenges right there. They're going to be things in it that people are not going to necessarily understand what you're doing, and you're going to have people that try to throw stones at you about you trying to do what it is that you need to do. You know what I mean? But see, blessed are those who forge the way for others, meaning that when you get your business to a certain level, now you can turn around and help other people if you just keep going and keep growing. When a lot of new people come into the ABS tribe, I say, and they say that they did this for the first time and they had this going on, and they were scared and they was doing this and that, I say, keep going and keep growing. That's what I tell them. So, and that's what we have to do. Keep going, keep growing, keep learning, because business ain't just getting business. There's a science to business.
Right.
Business ain't just getting business. There is a methodology, a technique, a way to do business.
Absolutely.
Okay? So you guys, as we read the other day in her book, that ignorance, that our ignorance can actually hurt our pocket.
Oh, and it does.
Come on.
It absolutely does. So that's why it is important, you know, to develop your skills and your ability to then educate yourself. You know, we should always try to educate ourselves in the field that we are going into. And really learning as much as you can about it. The more that you know about your business, the higher you're going to go and glow, because there are so many people that are in business that are not professional in their knowledge.
That's right.
You know, of their field that they're into. Right. If you ask me about copper and stones, I have knowledge, but there are those out there that have a lot more knowledge. So I'm always seeking more knowledge. And that's why I put on videos of other people, you know, sharing that information, because I'm learning from them the way you're learning from them at that moment. Okay?
Right, right.
So definitely that is an excellent point that you made, honey. I appreciate that.
Yes,
ma'am. Okay, so another idea that we had was like a resale shop, right? So online in most cities, they have.
I can explain this one if you want. So online, you have many avenues to get stuff for free. Now, you got Craigslist. People give away stuff on Craigslist all the time. You got Freecycle in a lot of cities.
Right.
People give away stuff all the time. People give away stuff on Facebook and as well. So if you go and you find stuff where people giving things away free, let's say they giving away a bed frame, right? And it's in good condition. And then you come up with a mattress. Now you got a bed that you can actually sell to somebody that you got for free, and you can charge what you want to charge on it.
Well, or, and refurbishing.
And refurbishing as well, if you want to do that, paint it or whatever you do to it. You know, so they give a host of things. Some people give away their old computers because they got a brand new one. I don't want this one no more. If you know how to upgrade computers, right? Now they just gave you a new base, right? To build a whole new computer from.
Mm-hmm.
So people give away things all the time. So you can look on there. People giving away dressers. People giving away refrigerators. People giving away many different things. So what you can do is, if you got a truck or can get access to a truck, if those things are in good condition, you go pick them up. You get you a storage place. Get you a storage place. If you don't have enough room in your garage or whatever, you get you a little storage place. You put that stuff in there. You take your pictures, right? And then you put it right back up on Facebook or Facebook Marketplace and other places like that, and you sell what it is that you got. You got it for free. You went and picked it up. you sell it, you profit off of it. You know, you can do that with lightly used clothes. It's the same thing like when you go to Goodwill. Right. Essentially, it's the same thing, but you transferring it online with people, with stuff that people giving you away for free.
Right. And see, that right there, especially if you're a do-it-yourself kind of person, and, you know, you go to the Home Depot and you get your paint, and, you know, you might want to take the old fixtures off of the drawers, you know, and put some new ones on there and put your little flair. You can decoupage it. My brother takes chairs, right, for the grandchildren, and he puts their pictures on the chair, all over the chair, kind of different things that they like. If their favorite thing is pizza, he may, you know, take a picture of a piece of pizza, you know, and then put it on there and then shellac it. And those chairs last a lifetime. And those children absolutely love their chairs. Don't nobody better not sit in their chair, because that's the chair Poppy made for them. You know, so things like that you can do if you always loved pictures. Let's say if you were the kind of person that loved flowers, right? And flowers are a big thing for you. You can go and get real flowers, dry them, and then create a picture and a painting out of it, you know, for not necessarily you have to paint it, but create a picture, frame it, and sell it. Okay? I personally love pictures with texture.
Okay.
You know, I love pictures with texture. So something like that would be unique.
My brother Jermaine say he changed picture frames as a hobby.
See? That's beautiful. And people like that. Well, and picture frames can be kind of pricey. So if you spend some time at a resale shop, you can get some really nice frames, you know, for little or nothing. And you go and you take those and you refurbish them. You paint them. You can, you know, put some gold glitter on it. I mean, I've seen people do some stuff with items from the dollar store. They take some bowls, put them on top of each other. The next thing you know, you got a vase, you know, sitting on your desk that was a bowl. But they took some spray paint and glued, and hey, it was so amazing. And there's a market for things like that right now. People are at home shopping.
Right.
You know, and that leads me into my next one. If you are at home shopping, get paid for what you buy. How do you do that? You review it. You review it. Amazon has a program where you can review products that you purchase from them, and then you can get paid, or you end up getting the product for free, some kind of way they work it out. We haven't ventured into that, but that is something available if you just like to shop. You're a shopper. Right. You can get paid for that. Remember, there was a time when they had secret shoppers.
Come on,
you know, and you would go into the stores and, you know, they wouldn't know you were, you know, a secret shopper, and you would basically do a review of that store.
Right.
They have things like that available online now where, you know, you can be a secret shopper or review the products and unveil it. And, you know, this is what it was like. It was good. It was bad. It was, you know, whatever. So that is something that you can do if you're at home and you just, you know, don't have an idea of what to do. That's something that can be done, as well as drop shipping.
Come on.
Now,
come on, talk black about it now.
All right. Now, drop shipping is something that my husband and my son do on eBay, Amazon, and Facebook Marketplace.
Can I just jump in?
He can, because he knows more about it than I.
All right. Okay. Fam, brother Jermaine is just enjoying this conversation. He said, "You reading his mind and everything." I mean, and he's enjoying this because these are things he's been thinking about. You know, definitely, brother. If you haven't, and you want to know more about it, we got a good brother Jason King, who is the dropship bandit. That's what we call him. This brother making hundreds of thousands dollars a year. We're doing this drop shipping. I mean, we just starting out and we doing what we doing, but that brother is on it, and they know brothers that actually make millions of dollars that's doing the drop shipping. Now check this out. I'm just to show you all what I mean. So everybody's starting to get this Woojer the little music strap that makes your body vibrate and everything like that. So I saw it, and of course at this time it's at a discounted price. So what I did was I took it, I listed it on eBay for the regular price, right? Listed on eBay for the regular price, and then I sold it, and that product is now going to Hawaii because of that. My son does other things too, video games and stuff like that, and they buying pre-orders. I want you to hear this now. They buying pre-orders. He's benefiting off of pre-orders from games that haven't been released yet. He put a little bit extra on it, $5, $7 or something like that, and people are actually buying these games. When the PS5 and the new Xbox was coming out, if my son had actually had the pre-orders already, where he had it locked in, he made two sales, $800 in 20 minutes.
Yep.
But he couldn't facilitate it because the all the pre-orders were sold out. But they sent him this money, $800. And he had to send it back, but he made that money in 20 minutes, man.
Right.
So we telling you.
It's money to be made. And with the skills, learning a skill to heal, it's not all about the money. But of course, you know, if you're at home and you're unable to work, then of course the money comes in handy.
Yeah.
You know, and so these are things that you can do to really help you through your process.
Right.
Okay. So we kind of went over the resale shop / refurbish free items, or, you know, buying things inexpensively and, you know, just putting your touch on it.
Right.
You know, and if you look at some of these shows, they used to have that
garage. They got it called Flea Market Flip.
Right.
Flea Market Flip, where they do what she says.
Yes.
Going to the flea market, they take a bed and they make a chair out of it or something like that. Stuff like that. You know what I mean? And their bed, they pay $50 for it, and they end up getting $500 for it just because they painted it or did a little something extra to it, a little different. So if you got that creative skill, then you can go all over the board, family. It's money to be made out here. I'm not telling you it's not work, because it is work. I'm not telling you it's easy, because it's not easy. And you're going to have times when you do extremely well, and you're going to have times when things is going So that's why we have to have more than one string of income, because that may not be doing as well as you like. So you can do this over here. But I'm going to let her go on with other business ideas where you can learn a new skill while you're here.
That's right. Absolutely. And there's no real, it's not a rush. Like if you decide you're going to refurbish a dresser, it's not like, oh, I got to get it. It's got to be done in a week. No, you have time. You know, the time that you place on it.
Right.
Even whatever business, even with my jewelry, I had like a whole year that I didn't do any jewelry at all, but I had enough product to sell throughout the whole year.
Now that's a fact.
So, you know, you put the work in when you got the energy to put the work in. And when you don't have the energy to put the work in, you think about ideas that you could do when you get the energy again. You know what I'm saying? You're always thinking, you're always keeping it moving, but you know, you do have to work with your body, because some people are really, not physically able to do a lot, but your mind, as long as you got your mind, you can still work and make things happen.
Right.
All right. So we talked a little bit about food and catering, creating video development. My son mentioned that. That's a mental thing that you can, you know, work on your computer. If you're into video games and, you know, that's a passion for you, then you can do video reviews. You can review movies. If you sit around and Netflix all day long, and then you know how to sit back and be a critic, you know, on a movie.
Not just Roger and Ebert now.
Yeah, right. you could be Tony and Monique, you know? You know, two of y'all get together and you could do your YouTube video critiquing movies on Netflix. You know, you don't have to get paid by Netflix. You just create your own. People love you, love your review of things and your opinion and your thoughts. I mean, somebody to take the movie The Matrix and really break it down.
Come on. Look, let me drop something on my sports fans, all right? I'm going to show you something. Look at this. So you like your favorite team, the Bears or whoever, right? Okay, so most people don't think of this. They just love their team. But it's a way that you can benefit from your team. We want to give a shout out to Sister Laundra. Thank you for tuning in with us. You know, but look at this. So you love your team, the Chicago Bears, right? So just say an official jersey is $80. Why can't you charge $100, $120 for that official jersey? And then you're benefiting from the official jersey of your team. They buy it, you get it, you ship it to them or have it shipped to them, you never touched it.
Right.
So not only that, you can even sell other people's stuff. So if you really love sports like that, like she said, you can do reviews of games and then you can benefit off like things like that. Their jerseys, their sweats, their coats, their jackets. You can create a whole genre, t-shirt, you name it. You add on the extra little price for what they charging. Guess what? You created a business based on that. It was a young man that started a basketball review. Then he sold his Facebook page, he said, for like $100,000 because he had over 1 million followers on now.
Right. So these are skills you can use while you heal. There are many things that you can do and you should do something. Don't sit around and waddle in your pain. You know, don't sit and just say, I don't feel good today. That's not enough. Your life is so much more important than you going through the illness. That's not all of who you are. That's not all of who you have become. That is a part of your life that you are dealing with. And the sooner that you get yourself back on track to living, you will see the life come back into yourself.
I did,
family, because I tell you, for a year, I sat on that couch and I told my husband, I don't know what my next big thing is.
That's what she did.
When I was 18 years old, my life was so focused on my next big thing. What am I doing next? What job am I going to? Who am I going to, you know, help? What am I going to do? But I got to the point where I sat on that couch for a year. Of course, I didn't feel well. The toxins in the body were so extreme that my head wasn't clear. So it was something physical that I was going through. And I just didn't know. And it bothered me. Because I was like, honey, I don't know what my next big thing is. And, you know, he's an encourager. So, you know, he gave me words of wisdom. And he, you know, helped in my process of coming out of that. Of course, you know, going on to the dialysis and actually having these toxins come out the body has been helpful. And I'm careful on what I put into my body that the toxins don't keep building up to the point that it was before. You know, that's the goal right now, is removing the toxins out of the body. But we have to have that next big thing in our mind of what it is that we want to create. What do we want to see become a new reality for us? Because that's going to forge the way for your future. That's going to keep you out of the hospital.
Right.
Because I don't have time for the hospital. I got to get myself together because I got this coming up. I got a seminar coming up. I got an event coming up online of things that I want to do. Oh, this new product is coming up. I'm gonna have to do a review. So whatever it is, it's got to be that motivation, you know, to push you forward. So I'm gonna give you another idea. And another idea is for those that know how to sew. If you know how to sew, pull that sewing machine out. This is your hour. This is your time.
Come on now.
Make them face masks.
Yeah.
Make them face masks. Because people, we're going to be wearing it for a while. And now people want to look cute. So get your bling bling going on.
Yeah, I saw somebody with a glittery mask yesterday.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. It's going down. You know the divas. Divas got to have, they bling, and it's got to match. Yeah. So we need more than just black. You know, black is all right, but you know, a little red, a little pink, a little fuchsia. You know, whatever it is that you, you know, want to do. I have now, we're moving into the fundraising for Love My Kidneys. And this is one of our fundraisers. I, with the help of my husband and a few other people, over time, have come up with the logo of Love My Kidneys. And let me know how y'all like that. You know, it's the kidneys in the middle and the heart and all that's, I love my kidneys.
Yes.
I actually have a t-shirt now.
Right.
I didn't like the quality of it, so we're going to a different vendor, and I'm waiting on that product to make sure that it is excellent for you, because I only want to give you the best. And we even tried a face mask, but the face mask was really thin. And not worth my money, so I knew it wasn't worth yours. So we have now another sister who does face masks, and she actually does the printing also of the logo.
Come on.
So those will be coming out really, really soon, fam. Come on. That's another thing that we're working on, is producing that. So if you are a sewer, you can produce the face mask in as a wholesale to someone who wants their logo put on it. And then you employ somebody else who puts logos on the mask in order to give them a job. And then you're creating a job. You understand? Or creating a product.
Right.
You know, where you can have, you know, your sunshine, whatever, you know, picture you drew that you absolutely love and you want to see it everywhere and everybody else loves it, then you can put it on a t-shirt. And you can have a t-shirt business where you don't even have to have the t-shirts in your home. You can do the drop shipping on the t-shirts.
Come on now.
Okay. Or, you know, if you actually make more money when you have the product on hand, but then you got to have space for it and you got to be willing to take a loss, because when you're dealing with product, sometimes they sell, sometimes they don't. But you have control of either which way.
That's true.
You know, that you decide to go with that. But I know I was in the market for someone who, you know, does a nice face mask. And the first one, like I said, was one layer. It didn't cover. It was like it was cute. I'll show it to you all. But it didn't serve its purpose. If you're going to wear a face mask, it's supposed to protect you. So the sister that I found, she is two layers, and she leaves a pocket for a filter. So for me, that works. Because that's when I do my mask, which I do sell face masks, they're on my Etsy page. I work more with the superheroes and Thundercats.
Thundercats.
I have Thundercats and all of that other fun stuff. So those are, you know, available on my Etsy page. But that's what I like. Two layers. And I need the cotton. I need it to be something that is useful. When I go out in these streets where the coronavirus is, I need to be protected. So I like the two layers and able to have the filter. And we usually use a top of the line, the highest level that we can find to filter out bacteria and the small particles.
Right.
That you find. So that's a good idea. So if you sew, pull your sewing machine out. We need some clothes. We need some real cute clothes where we're not naked and undressed. I mean, I'm sorry. These clothes that they got in the store, they're not for modest women. They're not.
Men.
Right. With the skinny jeans and grabbing the man all around his area and stuff. No, that is not attractive. That's not, when I think of a man in a suit, you know, I'm thinking sharp.
Yes.
Not feminine.
Come on.
I don't want my man to be feminine.
Not at all.
You know, I need a man, you know. You know, so we need seamstress, we need tailors.
Yes.
You know, we need to teach our children that skill as well. So if you do know how to sew, and you could teach that too.
Yep. Shoe design. Those who you can do the little Converse kind of shoes and make specialty designs with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, Brother Jermaine, we dealing with that Thundercats, and we do like that. You love that cup as well. You know, if you want one, let us know.
It's on the Etsy.
It's on the Etsy page. It is available. I will drop it in the chat for those who might want to get that. I love my kidneys cup.
And look, guys, with these cups, the 50% of the profit is actually going to the center, to Love My Kidneys Center that we're developing, because we are getting our 501c3. So we're raising money for our 501c3 so we can be real legit as we go forward with helping our people to be educated about kidney disease and how to prevent it and how to heal from it. You know, it's a area that a lot of people are afraid to journey on. But see, I got a God that backs me.
Come on now.
And I got his servants that back me. So I don't worry about that. I'm moving forward. Whatever they got in my path, I'm jumping over. Okay? And I need you all to come and help me do just that. So thank you, brother. Please purchase the cup. And, you know, we would greatly appreciate that.
Yeah.
All right. So let's see. We had a couple of other. I had a whole lot of things on my list, you all. But
well, we still gonna have time on our next show at 3 o'clock on the Queen of Rap. So we gonna put a pin in it right there.
Let me say this.
Go ahead. She wanna do another.
The last one is jewelry, right? Holistic healing jewelry, and I have classes available on December 5th at 2 o'clock. So DM me. And I'll make sure to have it on this page as well. I haven't done a commercial for it, so I'll do a commercial about it. But you can learn how to design jewelry. You can actually go into jewelry repair. If all you want, when I was in Belize, I sold my jewelry, but I made a lot of money off of cleaning jewelry and repairing jewelry and repurposing jewelry.
And teaching classes
and
on
teaching
jewelry.
Classes. So, yeah. You know, it is a lot in that, and it is healing. I tell you, working with that copper, working with the stones, I have the opportunity to work with all of these different stones. Sometimes people want moldavite. You know, sometimes I work with the lava beads and the crystals and the amethyst. And so I'm receiving those benefits from those stones as I work with them. So, you know.
There's a piece that she did. I don't know if y'all, I'm trying to come in. This is a piece that she did right here.
And yeah, that's an amethyst.
That's chevron.
Right.
Amethyst there.
Right. I do have on my forever bracelet.
She got on her forever bracelet.
One of them is.
I got on mine too.
Right.
This is the chakra one. That one on the site as well.
Yes. So my point is, let's get busy. We got to get busy doing something other than soaking in our issues. Because the illness is not going to go away unless you make it go away. And part of our healing is staying busy, keeping our minds active, keeping our desire for life alive. You got to love life. Don't let what's going on in this world on that stupid box that they call the idiot box depress you. Don't keep looking at it as the world turns. Don't keep looking at, you know, all of their children. You know what I'm saying? You know, let's spend some time being creative, using that brain that the God gave you, using your heart. Because I know you still have love. I know you still have passion. You're hurt. You're upset that these things happen to you, that, you know, you shouldn't be sick. I said that for a long time. My uncle used to tell me, Natalie, you the healthiest big girl I ever known. You eat. Barely eat, and you eat all these vegetables. You know, I don't even understand why you're still a big girl. I didn't understand it either. But for whatever reason of what I was going through, it's all for a purpose. It's not going to be the rest of my life. I don't claim that for the rest of my life, because I have put more attention to my healing since I've gone through this thing dealing with the kidneys and healing, you know, from this disease in my body. Realizing that a lot of it is mental. A lot of it, you know, is things that I brought into my life. So now I'm healing and learning how to get it out of my life. But I'm excited, so excited about my life. I don't want my life to end. I don't want this disease to take me out of here. So that means I got to get active doing something to make it different, to make a new way. And I know it's a lot of people out there suffering, people who are in much worse condition than me, people who don't have the knowledge that I have. So it is my responsibility to share it with as many people as I can, to bring other people who are knowledgeable in this field onto the show, which we, for the new year, you all, 2021, Love My Kidneys is going to be off the chain.
Come on now.
Off the chain. We got people lined up wanting to be on our show to talk about not just kidney disease, but the healing process.
Yes.
That's what I like. I like the healing process. You know, we're going to get educated on how the kidneys function, how the kidneys work in the body, how these different medicines that the doctors send us.
You know, I love The Last Dragon, brother.
You know, how these things affect our body. We're going to be learning a lot of things in the new year, but I want you to be excited about 2021. I want you to just pray tonight. Your assignment, if you are depressed, if you are struggling with kidney disease and going to in-center and all of that is a weight on you, I want you to pray tonight that God gives you the strength to wake up tomorrow and make it better. And then go to work. Practical application. Take one of these ideas that we sent out. Go into your own heart, into your own mind. Think about what it is that you want to see in your life, what you wish could have been different in your life, right? If you didn't know that, all right, I know today is Thanksgiving, so I'm going to say it. Don't be mad because I say it, y'all. If you spent the last 20 years of your life eating chitlins, and now you know what them chitlins has been doing to your body, and they hurt you, don't be mad at yourself. Pick yourself up and never eat that stuff again. And then educate your family members as to why they shouldn't eat it either. Because it's killing us in our community. Our slave diet is killing us. I know we like the collard greens and the cornbread and the fat back and all that other stuff, but that is death and destruction to our bodies. You know, just because it tastes good, don't mean it is good. There are alternatives to what it is that you used to eat. Soul food was the food that was left over. The weed that we ate with collard greens and things like that was because we could not get to the better foods.
Right.
So we had to make it taste good.
Right.
And because we're God, we did.
Yeah.
You know, we made it taste good. That little hot sauce and all that ketchup and stuff you put on there, you put it on there to cover up the taste.
Right.
Because the stuff don't taste good.
Right.
You know, so you covering up the ham. And you, if you just ate ham, you ain't put no seasoning on it, there's no way you would like that meat.
Right.
My point, fam, is we have to think healthier. We have to live healthier. We have to be excited about life and doing things that's going to bring life and not death to us.
Right. And Brother Jermaine, you can hit us in the DM. I'd love to talk with you, brother, about, you know, whatever you want to move into doing with your business.
Yes.
You know, we're going to get ready to get out of here, fam. But we wanted to take a few minutes and dedicate a song to you all. We know that they not going to let us keep it on here. We don't own the rights to this music. And this is a song from R. Kelly, because we want you to know that you can fly. You can fly above your situation.
That's right.
You can fly above your circumstance. You can fly above your weaknesses. You can fly above your illnesses. We want you to know and believe that you can fly. I know some of y'all saying, well, look what R. Kelly did. None of us is free from sin, not making no excuses for what the brother have done. Okay, we all in the bathtub, but the song is relevant to what we're saying. So we're going to take a few minutes, and we want you to remember this, tomorrow is Shop Blacktastic all day. That's right, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. That's 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. We're going to be shopping Blacktastic, bringing Black vendors to Black dollars, shopping with Black people. Oh, right. My God.
All right.
So come on, come on. Come on now. So we already planning part two, the Kwanzaa Shop Blacktastic. We already planning that already. So look, fam, come on, be with us on Shop Blacktastic. We got personal care items. We got Black comics. We got lip gloss and all kind of stuff. We got a DJ gonna be there.
That's right.
We got a on the spot artist. You're gonna send your picture in, he gonna draw it right there. You know what I mean? We got a lot of things that's going on tomorrow. Come on, be with us and Shop Blacktastic, family.
Yeah, shop,
go ahead
shop,
on and shop Blacktastic. Share.
When you see the commercial, I want to see it on your timeline. Share it with your friends and your family and let them know to come on over. We're going to be doing the fundraiser, starting the fundraising tomorrow for Love My Kidneys. And we're going to be selling a host of items. And man, I love you all. We love you all.
Yes.
And we just want to see us succeed. We know that the victory is already ours.
Come
we
on
just got to walk into it.
That's right. So look, fam, with that, join us again at 3 p.m. We're going to do it at 3 p.m. That's going to be the Queen of Rap. We're going to continue in this conversation, in this line. Everything today is about doing for self.
Right.
So we going in that line because tomorrow we're going to Shop Blacktastic.
That's right.
So come on, Shop Blacktastic with us. All right. So look at that, fam. We're going to go ahead. We dedicating this song to you as we close out. They're probably going to take it off. But if you haven't heard it, please hear it now. You can find it on YouTube, okay? All right, so we're going to play that. Enjoy. You all have a wonderful rest. Again, come on and join us on the Queen of Rap at 3 p.m. That's Mountain Standard Time, 2 p.m. Central Time.
That's right.
All right, enjoy. Believe you can fly above your circumstances, fam. We know you can. That's why we dedicating this song to you. Oh yes, also we put in the chat a lecture for those who wanna check it out by the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan called God's Healing Power to Heal the Black Man and Woman in America. Check that out.
Think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. There are miracles in life I know. cross a sheep. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can show. I see there are the open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Yeah, cause I believe in me.
I believe in you.
Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can do it.
I can do it.
If I just believe. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly.
Come on, join us at 3 p.m. on the Queen of Rap. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum, fam. Have a great day.